Matthew Sucky here from Verity Baptist Church Manila, providing you another video on the topic of Calvinism and the perseverance of the saints. And so Calvinists believe that if you're really saved, you're going to persevere unto the end. And that's really the proof of whether or not you're saved is if you do persevere. If there is no change and you're not walking the walk, maybe you never really got saved. Well, there's a major problem with that. There's a giant elephant in the room that they don't want to talk about. And that's the fact that you see believers in the Bible commit some pretty bad sins. You look at King Saul in the Bible. King Saul was a believer. Samuel's very clear that King Saul went to heaven. He said, tomorrow, in 1 Samuel 28, tomorrow shalt thou and thy sons be with me. What's the last thing King Saul did? He committed suicide. He persecuted David, and then he ended his life and committed suicide. But Samuel promised, tomorrow shalt thou and thy sons be with me. Now, I don't think you're going to find too many Calvinists that would believe that King Saul's in heaven, but it's plain as day in 1 Samuel 28 and 1 Samuel 31. But even if you reject that, what about King David? What about King David? David was saved, and then he committed adultery with Bathsheba, and then he had her husband put to death. And you say, well, you know, he repented, he came back to God. He didn't repent anytime soon. The only time he repented and came back to God and was sorry was when Nathan rebukes him. But there's a long period of time where he just lives in sin. And look, you know what? If he had died during that time period, he still would have gone to heaven. Why? Because when you're saved forever, because you're preserved in Jesus Christ. Once saved, always saved. And so he committed some really, really wicked sins. And so look, he didn't really persevere unto the end. You say, well, he came back to God. Yeah, but what if he had died when he was still living that life of sin? Then he didn't persevere unto the end. See, that's ridiculous to say that David, and so what some Calvinists try to do is say, well, I guess David wasn't saved until after he committed adultery. I mean, how stupid is that? Nathan comes to him and rebukes him because David should have known better as a believer. It's not like he was the guy who killed Goliath, the guy who was a man after God's own heart. He wasn't even saved. I mean, that's what people like Ray Comfort imply, and it's like, what are you talking about? Of course he was saved, but he didn't persevere unto the end. You say, well, yeah, that's Old Testament. That's different. Well, what about Demas? What did the Bible say? Demas hath forsaken me, having loved the present world. See, Demas decides to go back to the world. He goes back to his old desires, whether he's chasing after money or he loves the entertainment, whether he's got friends he doesn't want to reject or family. I don't know what it is, but he loved the present world, and he departs from Paul. Now, Demas was still saved. He didn't lose his salvation, but, you know, obviously he didn't persevere unto the end. I suppose Calvinists would say, well, I guess he wasn't really saved. And so they're going to do that to just anybody in the Bible. But you can look at Paul the Apostle, and he said he was a carnal Christian. And so this idea that if you're saved, you're going to persevere unto the end, it's not reality. And anyone who watches this video knows that in their personal life, look, sometimes you choose to commit sins. Sometimes you do what's wrong. Sometimes you go to bed at night and you don't have the clearest conscience because you know you didn't live the most godly life the previous day. This idea that if you're really saved, you're going to walk the walk and be a great person, it's ridiculous. And anybody can say that. Anybody knows that. Only an extremely prideful, arrogant person could honestly look at their life and say, man, I just always want to live right. Man, I never have a desire to do anything wrong ever again. That's ridiculous. The Bible promises we're preserved in Jesus Christ. It does not promise you're going to persevere unto the end. There's so many people in the Bible that were believers that did not persevere unto the end. Thank you, and God bless.